Hello everyone and welcome. I am Charity Hange from Wharfish Bay Corridor Group Marketing and Communications Department. With me today is the Deputy Director Transportation Policy at the Ministry of Works and Transport, Ms. Cynthia Haimbodi, here to speak to us about transportation policy and the logistics master plan. Welcome, Ms. Cynthia.
Thank you for having me.
Cynthia, without further ado, let's get into the first question. How does Namibia's current transport policy and regulatory environment ensure the successful implementation of Namibia's logistics hub master plan?
The vision of the transport policy of 2018 mm-hmm. is to build an integrated, mm-hmm. sustainable, and inclusive transport policy mm-hmm. that is cognizant of Namibia's opportunity to contribute to international and regional connectivity. That said, the policy focuses on a number of areas mm-hmm. that we should concentrate on as transport. And one of those areas is intermodal transport and logistics. Mm. Under intermodal transport and logistics, that is where we have the focus on Namibia being a logistical hub mm-hmm. for Southern Africa as well as internationally. Mm. And the policy sets out clear recommendations and reforms that should be undertaken in order for us to ensure that we successfully implement the dreams or the ambitions of the logistics master plan.
Mm. Right, thank you so much for that clarity. As Deputy Director at the Ministry or Deputy Director of Transportation and Transportation Policy, tell us in your opinion as to how the Namibian government will ensure the development of adequate transport infrastructure in to unlocking cross-border trade and stimulate economic growth.
Thank you again for asking. I think in my view, the Namibian government is already doing exactly that. Mm. I think we do have a number of projects that are ongoing. Some have been completed mm. that already speak to us unlocking this economic growth or trade opportunities that are on our transport corridors. I think I will mention a few of those projects, mostly in the road subsector mm. As well as in rail. There's been a number of road constructions as well as upgrades that have been happening mm. over the past few years and for the next 10 years and beyond to come. And these road projects have been meant to connect arterial roads to our transport corridors. Mm. If I can mention two examples, we have the construction of a road from Hobabes through Oshinene mm-hmm. and Grootfontein. This road is meant to connect the TKC, the Trans-Kalahari Corridor, to the Wawispe-Ndola-Lumbumbashi Corridor that comes from DRC, Zambia through Namibia. We also have a number of projects, for example, Henty's Uis Road that has also been constructed. Mm. And that road is meant to as well connect the TKC Corridor to the Trans-Kunene. So in my view, I think government has been doing very well on in investing in infrastructure mm. and as well as improving our networks mm. and I think once this is done we'll definitely be able to connect Namibia to regional areas as well as internationally.
Mm. Okay, now Ms. Cynthia, before we round up with this discussion, is there anything else that you'd like to say to the public out there?
Thank you. I think what I would like to just indicate is that we have the transport policy of 2018 that was mentioned earlier. This is a guiding tool that every transport player should have. The policy is meant to guide us on what exactly it is in the transport industry that we are trying to attain. And I think it's very important that all our stakeholders get a hold of a copy of the transport policy and have a look at it to fully understand exactly what reforms mm. or what recommendations the policy is giving and what is our focus area mm. that each subsector should be able to follow and implement if we are to achieve the vision of us becoming an integrated, inclusive, the vision of us having to build an integrated, sustainable and inclusive transport policy. Thank you.
Well, Cynthia, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for
Hoping
having me.
Hoping to hear from you soon again.